If you want to apply an effect mask to a moving object within your scene, you're going to have to keyframe it. We're going to show you how to do that right now.
Here we have a clip of an interview. It looks okay, but let's take it to the next level. A good way to draw attention to your subject is to apply a sharpen effect across their eyes. To apply the effect, we'll navigate to the effects menu on the right. We'll go to the blur category and locate the sharpen effect. And we'll drag it to our clip. Now, we'll adjust the effect until it looks just right. Navigate to the inspector on the top right corner. If the inspector isn't showing, be sure to toggle this icon. And make sure to click this video inspector button. In the effects section, click on Show to reveal the effects and their controls. We'll tweak the amount of the sharpen effect just a bit. Be careful not to add too much, it may look artificial. Now, we'll apply a shape mask by clicking on the Apply Effect Masks button and choosing Add Shape Mask. We'll apply the shape mask to the eye area using the on-screen controls. If you want to know how to edit your shape masks, check out the tutorial linked in the description below. Now, navigate back to the timeline and position the playhead to the frame where you want to add the first keyframe. In this case, we'll keyframe the beginning of the clip, and in the viewer, we'll position the mask across her eyes. Then, navigate to the inspector and click on the keyframe icon to the right of the shape mask. Next, move the playhead forward in time to when we need to reposition the mask back into place, and we'll adjust it in the viewer. Another keyframe will automatically be added since we adjusted the shape mask's position. Continue adding keyframes by moving the playhead to the next spot and adjusting the mask in the viewer. Once you've added all your keyframes, press space to watch your masked effect in motion. It may be a subtle change, but sharpening the eyes of your subject really draws the viewer's focus to that area, making for a more enjoyable viewing experience.
In conclusion, when dealing with moving objects in your scene, keyframing your mask is the way to go.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
If you'd like to see the next episode in this series, or the past one, or the future one, and